account of biblical scribes. Nothing is reliable, it's just, you know, a matter of concoction. If there is no evidence from God, and there is no need for God to keep such records. They are irrelevant to the issue of their truth. Now, that is for the time being, but as far as Jesus' birth is concerned, that also is debated among his own followers, Christians. You know, some say that the year, Christian year, era, actually started 4 years before his birth. So he was already 4 years old when the era started. So when there is so much difference of opinion, how could he expect me to tell him the exact date of birth of Jesus Christ? And to what avail that would be? Now, you better return to your original places, talk to each other and satisfy, try to satisfy each other. Okay?
Okay.
Yes, please.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum rahmatullah.
I'm Tahir Ijaz from Winnipeg, Canada.
From?
Winnipeg, Canada.
Yes, right.
Okay.
How are you, Tahir? When did you come?
I arrived, well actually I'm studying at Stanford for 3 months.
Achha. What was the purpose of your visit to Canada, to America?
I'm doing training in radiation cancer medicine.
I see. Okay.
Okay. And the question is, we observe in nature that there are many imperfections and faults. For example, children can be born without eyes or defective kidneys.
Yes, that's right.
Or we wear glasses, so the eyes imperfectly designed.
Yes.
How does one explain the apparent paradox and contradiction?
What is the apparent paradox? I don't see any apparent paradox at all.
That the
congenital defect in my vision, so that I can't see this apparent paradox, which is apparent to you. Where is the paradox? What does paradox mean?
What I thought was, the perfect creator, Allah.
If it were a paradox, then it would be presumed that God has claimed that in my creation I will distribute happiness and misery exactly equally. And everybody will be fed equally, everybody will be provided with equal strength and equal faculties. If that were the claim of God about his own plan of creation, then of course it would be a paradox. But I don't read such a claim anywhere in any divine book. Have you read any?
No, but what I had in mind...
Tell me, you are a scientist, aren't you? Tell me if there was not uneven distribution of happiness and satisfaction, could evolution proceed a single step forward?
Well, you need there's sacrifice of those who are, of things that are imperfect.
What I'm saying is, could evolution take place on the road to, you know, higher species, etc., a single step, if all the members of the species, which was the first known species on earth, were completely equally fed, equally preserved, equally protected, and they were not threatened by anything? Will there be any movement forward in the wheel of evolution or not?
No, I mean, you need, the evolution cannot proceed
without. Okay. So, misery and content, loss and gain, are two wheels of the caravan of evolution. And you cannot conceive of one without the other. So it's a much deeper question and much more profound issue than what meets the eye. Why accidents? That's another question. Why congenital defects? Is yet another question. Is it because man has been misbehaving and some of his misbehaviors have gone deeper into his genes, and some of the disease products have attacked the very cells which are responsible for reproduction, or is it just accidental? Now, even this issue is to be resolved before one begins to answer or form this question which you are forming. Mm-hmm. Now, it's a long discussion, I know. It will take up most of the time tonight and tomorrow as well. So, I tell you one thing, you should be glad to learn that in my book, which is now about to be printed, in which I have dealt with the issue of reason, knowledge, truth and revelation, I have taken up this very subject. And when you go through it, then if there are any remaining questions, inshallah, I'll be very happy to answer them.
What's the title of the book?
Pardon?
The title of this book?
I think it will be ready within...
Title. The name of the book.
Title?
Yeah,
the title, you mean?
Yeah, right.
I'm sorry. You know, sometimes I fail to understand American English. You know? I'm sorry. I hope the same is not true of you vis-a-vis my English. You see, the title, as I said, was Reason or Rationality. I don't exactly remember, but I think it's either Reason or Rationality. Knowledge, Truth and Revelation. This was a title suggested to me by the professor of, I think it was some scientific faculty in University of Zurich. The head of that department suggested this title to me for my proposed address in that university. The background is that he became known to some Ahmadis. He came perhaps to some question answer sessions or otherwise he read some literature and he became interested. He wanted me to introduce Ahmadiyya view to the university students, but he was afraid that if the students knew it was a religious leader who was coming to address them, none would turn up for audience, because he told me that if you compare this university with other universities, the larger number of atheists, percentage of atheists, is found in the University of Zurich than anywhere else in the world. This was his assessment. He said they just are not interested in any religious topic. So if I gave you a title which was apparently religious, they would not turn up, they would not be interested. So he said, I didn't say myself, but the missionary in charge then at that time, he inquired from him what he would suggest instead. So this was the title which he suggested. He said, I know they're philosophical. They're interested in the issue of rationality, what it means, what it stands for, what is knowledge, what is certainty in knowledge, and truth in relation to a knowledge being true and right. So these are very interesting issues debated from the times immemorial by man. So he said, I will add one word, revelation, to that, thereby giving you an opportunity to enter through that window into the realm of religion and then tie it up as you please. So that was a very wise, I think, and very kind gesture at his part, and I followed it. Now this was delivered, this speech, a few years ago, but it has a very